already.
The witch had a hat and a very tall hat, a long ginger hair, but she wore a necklace. How the kids pooed, how the cat pooed, and how the cat grinned.
Which grinned.
As they sat on the broomstick and flew through the wind. But how the witch wheeled and how the cat's back from the wind. When the wind blew so widely, it blew off the hat.
So it did. Ace!
Down cried the witch, and he flew to the ground. They searched for the hat, but no house could be found. Then out of the bushes and thundering paws, they bounded a dog with a hat in his paws. He dropped it politely and eagerly said, as the witch pulled the hat firmly down on the head, I am a dog as keen as can be. Is there room and a broom for a dog like me? Rah! Cried the witch.
Yes,
cried
the witch.
And the dog clambered on. The witch tapped the broomstick and whoosh, they were gone. Over the field and over the forest they flew. The dog wagged his tail and the stormy wind blew.
The witch laughed aloud
and held onto her hat, but anyway,
a wee blew the
ball off a long ginger flat.
Oh no. What's the next bit?
Down, cried the witch, and it flew to the ground. She threw the ball, but no ball could be found. Then out of the tree,
with a splitting shriek,
they flew a green bird with a bow in her beak. She dropped it politely and bent her head low, then said, as the witch tied her glass in a bow, I am a bird as green as can be. Is there room on a broom for a bird like me? Yes, cried the witch. So the bird fluttered on.
The witch
tapped the broomstick and whoosh, they were gone.
So that's another one. Alright, what's the next bit?
Over the reeds and the mountains they flew, the bird flew quickly and the stormy wind blew. Shot through the sky
into the
back of the beyond. The witch fluttered on her bow, but let go of her wand.
Oh, silly witch.
Down cried the witch, and they flew to the ground. They searched for the wand, but no wand could be found.
Oh, dear.
All of a sudden, from out of the pool,
pond,
leapt out with some dripping wet frog with a dripping wet wand. She dropped it lightly and then said with a croak as the witch dried her wand on the floor. frog as clean as can be. Is the room on a broom? Robert frog like me? Yes, cried the witch. So the frog bounded on. The witch tapped the broom to ambush the ribbon over the mountains and
over the
moons.
Moors.
And
mountains
they flew. The frog jumped for John.
And
the broom snapped in two.
Oh,
down
no.
Fell the cat and the dog and the frog. Down fell the... Down they went tumbling into a bog. The witch hawk's broomstick fell into a cloud.
They went to a cloud.
And the witch heard a roar that was scary and loud.
Uh-oh.
I am a dragon, as mean as can be. I'm planning to have wit and chips for my tea. No! Cried the witch, flying higher and higher. The dragon flew after her, breathing fire! Help! Cried the witch, flying down to the ground. She looked all around, but no help could be found. The dragon drew nearer and licking his lips. This
said,
maybe the swans will have chips.
Which without chips?
Which without chips. But just as you plan to begin on this feast, from out of a ditch was a horrible beast. It was tall, dark, and sticky, and fierce, and
feathered
and furred. It had four feet per head, and
had
wings like a bird, and its foot. And its terrible voice, as it started to speak, was a yowl and a growl and a croak and a shriek. It dripped and it squelched as it strolled from the ditch, and it said to the dragon, "Buzz off, that's my witch."
Buzz off, that's my witch.
The dragon drew back, and he started to shake. I'm sorry.
He spluttered. I'm sorry, he spluttered. I
made a mistake.
It's nice to have met you.
It's nice to have met you, but now I must fly. But and he spread out his wings and was off through the sky. The dragon.
Oh, and down flew the.
Down flew the bird, and down jumped the frog, down climbed the cat, and phew, says the dog.
Keep on.
And thank you, oh thank you.
And phew, said the dog, and thank you, oh thank you, the...
For it, without you, I won't be in the dragon's inside.
Oh dear, I don't want that.
Then she filled her cauldron head with her brain. Find something everywhere. Throw something in. So the cat, the frog found the lily, the cat found the corn, the bear found the twig, and the dog found the bone. And all the but dogs do. They threw them all in, and the witch stirred them well. And as while she was stirring, she misunderstood. Liggity, ziggity, zangity, zoo. Then rolled out a magnificent broom. With seats for the witch and the cat and the dog, a nest for the bird and a shower for the frog. And yes, cried the witch, and they climbed on.
And they all clambered on.
And they all clambered on. The witch tapped the broomstick and whoosh, they were gone.
Is that the last bit?
The end.
The end.
That's the story of Room and a Broom, Granddad.